you beauty pageant lovers, welcome to yet another episode of Lockdown Diaries with me, Hesha Chima. Today, who I have on the show is not just an inspiration as far as your physical beauty is concerned, but she's that one amazing woman who also promotes, and not only that, but also believes, practices, and helps talk about mental health and living a healthy lifestyle. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you, Shefali. How have you been?
Thank you so much for such a nice and warm introduction. I've been good. I think that this lockdown has been slightly easier to deal with because I feel like we've already been through one. So we are a little more prepared. But looking at the situation on ground, it's not ideal. But, you know, I just hope we get out of it as a society, as a country.
That's so true, right? Like, we have been through a part of it before, so we do sort of know what to expect. But I think it's yet such an unknown territory, right? Ali, I really want to know, and I'm sure it's not just me, it's also the curiosity of a lot of other people out there, that what is it that you've been doing in this lockdown 2.0? What is it that's keeping you busy?
I've always found things for myself to do. I don't know if you know this, but I'm an avid reader, so I read a lot. I've also started putting in a lot of thought in my social media, so I've created a ton of content that I want to post. Some of it is entertaining, some of it is educational, some of it is knowledge-based, but I'm not posting anything at the moment because I just want the situation to get a little better. I want people to be in the right headspace to be able to absorb it.
I mean, not just me, I think everybody knows that you have been a business student. You've been a beauty pageant winner. You know, you have titles attached to you for not just one, but multiple pageants across. More so, you're also somebody who's a lifestyle coach. You've been a buddy mentor to our diva aspirants. I mean, how is it that you manage all of it? Like, don't you think 24 hours is too less for you?
On some days, yes. But like everybody else, some days I struggle to fill up those 24 hours with something to do. I think it's both. I think the ultimate objective is to find something that you're really passionate about. And I think that passion fuels everything else. You know, when you're really passionate about something or when you have a clear goal in front of you, regardless of what it is, then your subconscious intuitively knows which direction you have to go in. So new things keep coming up. Consider myself an artistic, a creative person. But some days I think, oh my God, you know, what if I run out of ideas? I think that's a very scary thought for me. But some days, you know, ideas just flow. They keep flowing and new content keeps coming up, new things to share. So I think just the secret or whatever you want to call it is to have something that you're really passionate about, and everything else is just a consequence. It's an inevitable consequence.
But you would probably have experienced your own shares of, you know, mental breakdowns, ups and downs, etc. Generally in life, for you to right now be at this point wherein you can actually pinpoint, hey, you know, this is a negative thought pattern, I need to change it. How has that journey been for you?
You're right. It has been a lot of struggle. It has been, you know, especially with my mental health and emotional health. I've always spoken about it openly. It took me a while to be able to come, you know, out in the open and speak about it. But I've struggled a lot with resolving, you know, childhood baggage that I've carried with me, baggage that I've carried with me from relationships and friendships, and to just sort all of that out. It's been a really long journey and I feel like it's an ongoing one. One thing that I realized very recently is that you can be a work in progress, but you can still contribute. You know, it doesn't have to be that first I'll heal and then I'll give my best. You can balance the two.
And Shefali, you were a buddy mentor for Adeline Castellino. How does that make you feel? I mean, it's a little bit of pat on the shoulder, right?
I don't know if I can take any credit for it, to be honest. But I will definitely say this, that, you know, I had the privilege of speaking to all the girls for a very a substantial amount of time. And when I was speaking to Adeline, for me, I think one thing that is the key to winning at life is preparation. You know, so I said it then and I'll say it now that Adeline was somebody who was perhaps the most well-prepared candidate of the lot. Not only had she put in the work to be there, but she also had a lot of knowledge that she had gathered to back it up. You know, so it was not just that performance of 30, 35 days, 40 days. It was also all that she's gathered for the past 2 years or whatever X amount of time that she's been preparing. There is a certain warmth in your heart when you see someone else living out and getting to be where they deserve and where they've worked to be. So I think that's really incredible.
Pali, I think, you know, you've been somebody who's had that whole pressure or the responsibility of representing India, you know, that too globally. At that point in time, when you were actually going through that, what was it that was running in your mind? Like, I really want to know now, when you reflect back on it, how did you take it?
I think that for the first few days, I was overwhelmed, but at the same time, it was so surreal. You know, I couldn't believe that something that I'd worked for so many years had finally come to fruition. But overall, I think I oscillated between that sense of responsibility and gratitude, because I would have to take a moment to remind myself, you know what, Shivali, it's happening. You dreamt of this for so long and it's finally happening. So just take a beat to be grateful. And
Shivali, are you someone who believes in the law of attraction?
I have always believed in spirituality and the law of attraction. People are moving towards spirituality. Rather, they are coming back to spirituality, because whether we realize it or not, we are all spiritual beings. We are all made of energy. So I think it's a really big paradigm shift that's happening in the world right now. And yeah, probably it's because of the pandemic, when all the external things that have fueled our generation are taken away. There is nothing left but yourself, you know, the very essence of who you are, and that is spirituality.
So that brings me to my next question. Have you been reading any books in this lockdown?
So currently I'm reading this book called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself. It's been written by Dr. Joe Dispenza. I feel like it's one of the most revolutionary books ever written on this topic, and it really gave me a lot of perspective. And the second book that I'm reading is How to Do the Work. It's a new release by Dr. Nicole. She's known as the holistic psychologist. She has some 3 million followers on Instagram. That's how I discovered her account. But yeah, these two books are really, really shaping the way that I, you know, think.
But have you also been simultaneously binge watching any shows on Netflix or doing something like that? Or like, no, that's not my thing.
I've been watching this show called Parenthood on Amazon Prime, because I finished every good show there is to watch on Netflix. I also recently finished this show called Shadow and Bone, which was a new release on Netflix. It was really an interesting show, something different.
Great. Shivali, I want to sort of wrap up this interview by asking you just one more question, which is that you might be aware that, you know, the whole pageant format right now, given the preceding times, has moved digital. You know, and your time was really, really different, you know. Do you think, or do you picture yourself, probably if you had to participate in this digital era, how would that journey be for you? Would it be any different, or you're just very happy the way, you know, your journey was in the past?
You know, moving the pageant online has made it really accessible for a lot of women who may not have had the resources to travel. But having said that, certain things cannot be achieved over an online platform. Energy or what somebody really looks like, you know, right? So, but if I had to participate, you know, in the digital era, then I definitely think that it would be a bit of a challenge to stand out, because everyone has the same resources. The playing field is literally, you know, evened out. Right?
Yeah.
Everyone has that one smartphone or one phone, and then, you know, it's all about you. So I definitely do think it's a bigger challenge to take the pageant format digital. But yes, I would be excited to see, if I ever had to participate in that, how it would turn out.
With that, I think we are going to come to an end of this particular session of Lockdown Diaries with you. It was so good to have you. And I hope, Shivali, that you also enjoyed chatting with us as much as we enjoyed chatting with you.
It's always a pleasure. You know, I always say this, that you come up with the most insightful and thoughtful questions, and I think that's an interviewee is almost as good as the interviewer. You know, you make me think. Otherwise, interviews are, you know, not to brag, but they come very easily to me. But with you, I always go that extra mile. I always have to challenge myself, and I think that's really incredible. So thank you for being such a great host.
But thank you so much for kind words. You are always somebody who's extremely warm, happy, positive, no matter what's going on in the background, you know, to sort of keep us motivated and challenging ourselves time and again. So thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
You lovely people who tuned into the episode of Lockdown Diaries with Shivali and myself, thank you so much for watching it. I'm sure there's a lot of takeaway from this episode that you have from Shivali and her experience and all the amazing motivational pep talk she always gives us to move forward in life. Keep safe, do the regular bits that we always hope that you do it for us, which is like this video, share this video with your friends, comment below and let us know if there's anything more that you'd like to ask Shivali, and I will make sure that she comes back again and answers all those questions for y'all, and we shall see you again super soon. Bye-bye and thank you so much. Keep safe.